Avi Myers, Northtown Neighborhood News Magazine. Early voting starts Monday. Vote, 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 vote. And this is pretty much your last chance to call me about Jewish Chicago, because sometime later tonight, literally, I'm going to be pushing the button to send it to the printer so we can have it out for the start of early voting. Thanks to my entire technical crew, Sonny Hirsch, and I want to thank Kelly Tarrant, who's made her first appearance here today together with my next guest, who people have reminded me that in the first issue of the primary issue of Jewish Chicago, when I went through all the Democratic lieutenant governor candidates, I said it was a slam dunk and people should vote for Scott Lee Cohen.
You did.
And,
yes, you did.
Yeah, I did. So how you doing, Scott?
I'm doing good, Avi. Thank you for having me on the show again.
First of all, my pleasure. And, the campaign's in progress.
It's in progress. It's going unbelievably great. I'm very thankful. Tremendous amount of support. It looks good.
There's a lot of people that really like you. And
you know what? Again, I've always been honest with the people. I've put my heart and soul into this campaign. And I'm going to run the state with my heart and soul. And I think that that's resonating with the people. I think the people are seeing that.
I think so, too. And I think the same way that they voted for you last time, I think they're going to see what's going on. Well, listen, let's take a look at what you got. You've got Quinn, and I'll let you do the campaigning, who's pretty much shown us that he is not capable of being a good governor. And you've got Brady that's going to polarize everything. I mean, if they would have put a moderate Republican in there, I think they might have had a shot.
Well, you know, if they would have put a moderate Republican in, let's be honest, I wouldn't be running right now because I think that it would be a hard candidate to beat. But the fact is, they didn't. Quinn is incompetent. And Senator Brady is too far to the right. You know, these are unprecedented times, and it's going to take some unprecedented measures to lead Illinois back to the right road. We need a middle-of-the-road type of thinking guy. Do you know what I'm saying by that?
Yes, I do, as a matter of fact, and that's one of the reasons you're sitting here right now and Brady and Quinn aren't.
No, yeah, absolutely. And I appreciate that, and I think the viewers will appreciate that. I believe in working hard, and I've told you this before. I'm not beholden to the Democrats. I'm not beholden to the Republicans. You know, they're fighting amongst themselves. They're fighting against each other. But in the meantime, and at the end of the day, the people of Illinois are suffering. You know, let's look at unemployment. You know, 10.5%, that's ridiculous. That amounts to 700,000 people that are without work. That's ridiculous.
It's huge.
Nuts, yeah.
And those figures only represent, those figures don't even represent some people who've been out of the workforce more than 6 months.
You know, speaking of that, we didn't.
Sure.
I had my job fair September 17th or 19th. I don't think we talked about that.
No, we didn't, as a matter of fact. But you know what? There's no question that one of the things, you know, a couple politicians said to me that they thought you won, you know, the primary because you addressed jobs and you went downstate.
You know what? I listened to the people. They could have done the exact same thing that I did. I'm not a genius or a rocket scientist. I'm just somebody who listens to the people. What I heard was jobs, 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 jobs. So, you know, I came back from downstate. I had my first job fair, and it was successful. And every time we have one, it gets more and more successful. There were 1,300 people that came through the last job
fair. Wow.
That was unbelievable.
And people are actually getting jobs from these things.
They're getting jobs from them, absolutely. Now, something that was new and unusual at this job fair, I had high school kids coming looking for part-time jobs.
Wow.
And that really impressed me, and that's something that I'm going to have to expand on, you know, going forward, because we're not geared for teenagers at these job fairs. And I never thought about it until they came. So at the next one, we'll be more prepared for these high school students. It's an interesting concept. You know, everybody thinks that college or high school students and college students are out there causing crime and destroying things, and they don't want to work. It's not true. It's all fictitious. They do want to work.
Yeah, I was working. I worked for my father. I was an Andy Frayn usher. I tried delivering papers for one whole day for
you
the Southeast
Economist. You were an Andy Frayn usher?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know that.
1967 Chicago Cubs, the first year they actually started winning games.
Unbelievable. You know, my father, when he was a kid, lived in New York.
Yeah?
He worked at the ballpark. Unfortunately, he got fired because you know what he used to do?
No.
He used to put his rack down, sit down and watch the game instead of selling his product, okay? That's my dad. Honest to God. Okay, so, you know, we all have our faults, right?
For sure.
I'm not perfect myself, but let's be honest here. The state doesn't need perfection. It needs honesty. It needs integrity. It's something that it hasn't had in many years.
Not only for men, I can't even think when it might have had it.
Yeah, you're right. And, you know, let's talk about something real quick.
Sure.
Let's talk about all these fees and fines, because many of your viewers are small business owners. And since 2002, the state of Illinois has implemented over 300 fees, fines, and penalties. The people want to know why the state of Texas is number 3 in the nation for job growth, and the state of Illinois is at the bottom of the list, number 46. This is a big reason why.
Yes, it is.
You know, and as governor, we have to remove most, if not all, of these fees, fines, and penalties. We've got to make Illinois more business-friendly so that these businesses can come here or stay here and compete in the global economy. It's just, it blows my mind that neither of the other candidates are really doing anything to come up with a solution to bring businesses back.
Now, they don't even if they wanted to have a solution, they wouldn't have a clue.
They don't. Well, but again, they're career politicians. They're not small business owners. And that's what separates me from the rest of the pack.
They wouldn't know the price of eggs.
No, they don't. They don't. And unfortunately, they don't hear the voice of the people. They really don't.
No, and I don't think they're interested in it either.
No, they're interested in protecting themselves and staying in office and
lining their pockets and putting their pension together, getting their relatives on the payroll, giving their best friends contracts, little things like
that. Listen, you just said it all. But you know what? This has to stop. And I've said this a million times. We're not only in an economic recession. We are in a leadership recession. And that's why it's so important for the viewers to get out and vote early and vote for somebody like me who is new and not corrupt by the system. Somebody like me that offers fresh ideas and a fresh perspective and who's going to work hard to move Illinois forward and bring the businesses back so we can get the people back to work. Quinn and Brady, they have no clue.
I agree. If people would like to contact your campaign?
The website, scottleecohen.com. The phone number is 312-441-0300. Let's get the lawn signs up. And I really believe on November 2nd, we can win this election and we can move Illinois forward. We can bring the businesses back and put the people back to work. I really do.
Scott Lee Cohen, thank you very much, and good luck in the election.
Harvey, thank you. It's always a pleasure.
My pleasure. And thanks, Kelly.